I've struggled with anxiety since I was in high school, but it wasn't until a few years ago when I made the connection between physical clutter and my mental health. Clutter directly impacts my mood, focus, energy, creativity, so I really love sharing these learnings with others. Taking one small step to tidy up your space has the power to unblock you from feeling stuck in so many areas of your life. And oftentimes, it will create a beautiful ripple effect where you make more positive micro decisions throughout your day. For today's video, I'm sharing 5 simple, very doable tips to create an inspiring space, one that makes you feel good so you can flow more freely in your day-to-day life. Let's go. The first tip is to embrace open space. One of the simplest takeaways when I first entered the mindful decluttering niche is that space doesn't always need to be filled. Open space is beautiful. It's freeing and it allows you to think more clearly. Whether it's your closet, your countertops, or your calendar, embrace the space and question if you have the urge to always fill it. How would it feel to leave that space open? I love leaning on organizers and bins to build structure. I'm a proud outfit repeater because a stuffed closet stresses me out. I also keep a wish list of things that I think I want, which helps me reduce impulse purchases because I have a chance to really think about it before making that purchase. We all have the power to make tiny shifts to align our spending with our values, and once you begin clearing through the mental, digital, and physical clutter, just be more intentional about what you allow back into that sacred space. The second tip I've got for you is to create peaceful pockets. When I want to go inward or just have some time to myself, I go to my little spot out on my patio. It's my dedicated happy spot. I'm surrounded by my plants. I can hear the birds, listen to music, and I can roll out my yoga mat and just breathe. I love to make a warm grounding drink no matter how hot it is outside. I know I'm strange. And even just 5 minutes phone-free in this little space can be so impactful. I think we often forget just how much we can get out of 300 seconds if we just take a moment to slow down, breathe, rest our eyes from the screen, and reset. And you don't need a patio space to create a peaceful pocket. I also have a meditation corner in my bedroom where I get some journaling in. No matter how big or small, carve out a pocket of your home that is dedicated to feeling good. Make it cozy, add some plants, and make it a space that you're excited to be in. My third tip is good music. Music energizes me, inspires me, calms me. Music has always been a big part of my life, and so I couldn't be more pumped to partner with Sonos to bring you this video. Here I have the Sonos Move, which is so simple to sync up with your phone and hop right into your playlist. I bring it out with me on my patio when I'm gardening. I use it in my garage when I'm working out. We hook it up to our projector for outdoor movie nights. It's amazing. I'll link the Move as well as one of my playlists down below that I have on repeat. It's mostly Korean indie music, which is what I listen to these days, but I love how I feel so much more inspired and connected to my culture than ever before, and music is a big part of that. Tip number 4 is plants. Plants are such a simple, beautiful way to invite more life and inspiration into your space. I'm obsessed with biophilic design, which is all about bringing nature indoors to make you feel good. You don't have to buy up the whole nursery. My plant collection has grown by swapping plants with my friends or propagating clippings from my current plants and then potting it to create more plant babies. Seeing something grow is very rewarding, so whether it's one plant or 50, bring on the green. My 5th and final tip is to change things up. When I feel like I need to breathe life into my space, I'll go shopping in my own home, AKA I go to different rooms and rearrange things. Maybe that white stool in the bedroom would look nice in the office. I love moving furniture around, swapping out plants, art, books, maybe adding a disco ball where the light hits, and just making something feel exciting and new without actually spending money. Those are my tips for creating an inspiring space. What small steps will you take to feel good in your home? Let me know in the comments, and I'll see you all in the next video. Bye for now.